These two, chef's kiss. Woo, not trying to get emotional. Feel me within, I'm gonna win. We got a question. Hey you guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new, if you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. My name is Tierra and I'm very excited that you are here. In this video, I'm going to be talking about, exactly as the title suggests, my journey to reading the Bible for the first time. The way that this video is going to be structured is going to be more like an interview. I'm going to be addressing the who, what, when, where, and why. So let's get to the first question. Who am I? I am a mother, I am a daughter, a sister, I am a children's book author, I'm a vlogger. I also have a blog called Warm Regards to Blog. I'm a wife, and yeah, I wear a lot of different hats. I've gone to church my entire life. I know Jesus. I know Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I'm a believer, and I'm actually a preacher's kid, funny enough. But I have never been able to successfully read through the entirety of the Bible, and I've always wanted to do it, but I just didn't know how to. And I felt very intimidated by the language that is often used in the Bible, because sometimes it's not very easy to understand. Like, I would literally, I would read one sentence and be crushed. Like, I could not get through a sentence, okay? And that's what one of the things that like really discouraged me from reading is just, I didn't understand it. Like, I really didn't. So that's what I would encourage you to do. First of all, if you are interested in reading the Bible or starting or anything like that, get a study Bible, because it breaks it down and makes it so much easier for you to consume versus just reading thou hast, whilst, like that type of vocabulary that you don't really hear all the time. So yeah, why now? So the reason why I'm going on this journey of reading the Bible is because I felt led to. There's so much going on in the world right now, and I didn't feel as equipped as I should given how long I've been a believer. And another reason is because I have my own family now, and it's not like I can just run to my dad, even though he's willing to like pray for my family and he does often, but it's not like, you know, I can just run to my dad or run to the pastor and every single time anything happens or every single time, you know, I need a prayer, that I just reach out to them to pray on my behalf. I have to be able to do that myself and for my family. I do strongly believe that we all should have a relationship with God for ourselves. So being equipped to be able to pray for your family, being equipped to understand who God is, are some of the reasons why I really felt led to do so. You always hear people saying that the end of the world is near, and there are so many different signs that are written out in the Bible and the book of Revelations that's like happening now in real time. I just want to be prepared, and I just want to really know what is supposed to happen, what the Bible actually says is supposed to happen. And I also want to gain a deeper relationship with God. And in doing so, something that stuck out to me, that I had a conversation with my dad a couple of years ago, and he was basically saying, when you have a relationship with someone and you claim to love them, you know who they are, you know what their personality is, you know all the ins and outs of who they are. And then he posed the question, how can a person say that they love God if they really don't know who he is? You know, they haven't really spent time with him and they haven't learned much about him. I feel like I've known who God is my entire life, but a lot of that is based off of what other people told me about who God is. I wanted to do the work and learn more about who he is for myself and also for my family. I think that that's like something that's super important, especially like it's so important for when anybody gives you any type of information, you go and you do the research and you figure things out on your own. And I think that's just the place that I'm at right now, is just being able to go and do the work and find out things on my own. By me reading, it has really opened my eyes to a lot of different things that I've heard my whole life, but I just never took the time to sit down and do the research, or I wanted to do the research and I just didn't really have the tools that I needed to do so. And I think another thing that I've really been excited about is just questions that I've had, and I would literally ask God, why, you know, does this happen, or I feel this way, can you give me more of an explanation on this particular thing? And the thing that has really, really, really touched me is the fact that I asked God a question and he literally answered it. And the way that he answered it, it may not be in the way that you think that he will, but he literally answered exactly what I needed him to answer. And it made me super emotional when I received the answer, because I just felt like there are so many people in the world right now, and for him to, and I know he's omnipresent, but for him to really hear something that I, a question that I had from my heart, and to answer me, that was everything to me. And it's just been really encouraging for me to just continue to push. I kind of went off on a tangent, and I'm gonna look back at my list of questions. Where are you in your reading? Following, so I told you guys I'm following like the weekly guide that's in the Bible in 52 weeks. So at the time of this recording right now, I'm currently getting through week 10. I've read Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Matthew. I'm almost finished with Proverbs. And I think I'm almost finished with Proverbs. And then I started Psalm and the book of Mark. Yes. I started Psalms and Mark, and I'm almost finished Proverbs. The Bible in 52 Weeks, a year-long Bible study for women. It's by Dr. Kimberly D. Moore. And here she is right here. So I absolutely love this book. So the way that this book is broken down is it'll show daily readings. So for example, I'll just show you the week that I'm on right now. So I'm on week 10, and the message for this week is I'm just a vessel. I don't know if you can, there we go. The message for this week is I'm just a vessel. And then at the bottom of the page, there are your daily readings. It has like a nice little message on the next page, or it just has a nice little message after that, after your daily readings, just explaining and bringing together all of the chapters that you are to read for the week. And I think that is amazing, because it's basically like Sunday service every day. Like when the pastor goes through and is able to connect things from the Bible and apply it to the way that your life is right now. It is just amazing. And I also love, she also includes like points to ponder and sometimes like a prayer at the end. So this has been like super, super helpful for me in just establishing like a easy structure to follow for reading the Bible versus reading front to back. The Bible that I have, this is in a case right now actually. And my parents actually got this Bible for me for Christmas. I don't think the front cover looks like it. No, the front cover doesn't look like anything spectacular. It just has like a symbol on the front, but it's the Women's Study Bible by NIV. On the inside, it shows like diagrams on different questions and stuff that you may have. Like if you are reading this and, for example, when God was talking to Moses and telling him how the tabernacle should be set up, he was telling him about the different altars that he wanted to set up, but the book actually shows what the altar would look like where the altars would be positioned and where like the most holy place would be, the Ark of Covenant, like all of that kind of stuff. It literally shows everything that you would want to see. It's been super, super, super helpful for me. My parents actually purchased this for me for Christmas because in one of my prior vlogs, I was talking about how I was searching for a Bible and I was just having such a difficult time trying to find one. I thank God that they gave this to me because, and this was actually my Christmas gift from them. And I was so happy. Like, this is one of my favorite gifts that I've received from Christmas. And it's just like, ugh. And then my husband got me the Bible in 52 weeks for Christmas. So these two, chef's kiss. Highly recommend these. I will put these in the description box below if you're interested in purchasing them. The last book that I've been using, and this isn't anything that I've been studying from, it's just for me to outline a lot of my goals that I have for myself. It is a 2024 Christian planner, and it is so, so nice and sturdy, and it comes with like so many different cool pages that I can write. Like, obviously it comes with like a calendar and all of that kind of stuff that you would typically see in a planner, but some other things that I like is that there is a section for a vision board. There is also, I'm not going to show this page because it has like all of my goals on it, and I just want to keep that to myself because it's just very personal for me. But it has a page for my healthy habit goals and 2024 goals. Absolutely love this. I don't know if it comes with stickers. I just jumped straight in and just, it has like folders in the back, I guess, so you can like, or a folder in the back so you can keep like papers and stuff, but I don't use that. I literally just write like my goals and stuff in here. And I think what's really been helpful for me is just when I am sitting down to do my Bible study and I'm reading, typically after I'm reading, I will open my 2024 Christian planner and I will just take a look at my goals. So it really helps me to stay on top of the things that I said I wanted to do. And it keeps me, it's like holding me accountable. And it's like, even times when I'm feeling like, oh, I'm tired, I don't feel like doing this, I just, you know, I'm just not in a mood to do this, or I just want to do something else in place of doing this right now. Reading that Christian planner with my goals that I set at the beginning of this year really forces me to stay true to the things that I wanted to do for myself and like all of the goals that I wrote down. But mainly one of my main goals is being able to get through the Bible in a year. So yeah, super, super helpful. Absolutely highly recommend all of these books because they've been super helpful on my journey to conquering reading the Bible. What have you learned and what are your takeaways? One of my takeaways is that I really wish that I would have done this a lot sooner. And I say that because as I'm reading, I'm realizing that I know so much more than I thought I did. I'm not gonna lie, I was a little bit embarrassed of the fact that I have not done this yet. And the fact that I am 34, I'm at this big age and I still have not read the Bible in its entirety, especially because I've been in church my whole life and like, you know, being a preacher's kid is like, girl. I'm happy that I'm doing it now, better late than never. I feel like, not trying to get emotional. I feel like I feel like in me spending more time with God than I did before, and in me trying to have a deeper relationship with Him, I'm seeing things transition in my life. I'm seeing things happen that, you know, I could only say it was Him that caused it to happen. And I'm just so happy. I'm so much happier that I'm doing this now versus, you know, not doing it at all. So, yeah. If this is something that you've been wanting to do for a long time, I would highly recommend that you do this. And then I think another thing that's really important is for you to connect with people who are also in the same space or who may know more, who know more than you do in this area. I know I can go to like my dad and ask him questions, but my best friend is a pastor. So a lot of times if there's something that I have questions about or I need more information on, or like if Google can't help me, or if I feel like Google is showing me something that I probably is a little taboo, 9 times out of 10, I can go to my best friend and ask her, what does this mean? Can you explain this to me in a way that makes sense to our life? Like, I've absolutely been loving that because I actually prayed to have a best friend like that. And the fact that I have that, that he blessed me with a best friend like that, that I can go to and ask these type of questions to, it's just been amazing. Another takeaway is in me reading and wanting a deeper relationship with God, it is helping me to hear the voice of God more. You want to talk to God so bad and you want him to respond to you, and all you have to do is try to get to know him, just like with a person. Like, you want to establish a friendship or a relationship with somebody, you have to spend time with that person, you have to get to know that person, you want to hear from them, you have to reach out to them. And I think because I'm reaching out and I'm trying, I think that's really been helping me to hear from him more. So one of my favorite gospel songs that tears me to pieces, okay, tears me to shreds every time I hear it, is a song called He Wants It All by Forever Jones. And basically in a song, they're talking about how there's a voice that cries out in the silence, searching for someone who would give him their all, give it all. He wants it all today. And that song breaks me down every single time. And it's like, all he wants is just someone to love him and to establish a relationship. And it just sounds like such a simple thing, but we make it so hard. We make it so difficult, and it doesn't have to be that way. Like, yeah. When will you be finished reading? So I already answered this question. The book that I'm following is The Bible in 52 Weeks. So 52 weeks from January 1st is December 30th. So I'll be completely finished my reading then. If I decide, which I don't foresee happening, depending on the situation, because a lot of times I'm not going to lie to you, when I'm reading and the story is really like good, like, or juicy, and I want to know more about what's happening next, like sometimes I don't stay within the guides of, okay, just read this chapter to this chapter. Sometimes I go beyond a chapter I'm supposed to read. So if that happens, which it does happen a lot, then I'll probably finish the Bible sooner than December 30th. But yeah, as of now, December 30th is the time that I'm going to be finished reading this. When do I find time to read? A lot of times it may be difficult for us to find time within the day to dedicate to reading, but I've noticed that I find time to do so much other stuff. Like, I find time to watch Love is Blind, okay? I find time to be on social media. I find time to record for YouTube and edit my videos and post online. Like, I find time to do all of that stuff. So if I can find time to do that stuff, then I can definitely find time to spend time with God. Like, I really, really enjoy reading at night, like when my entire house is asleep. I really enjoy just reading at night and spending time with God. The house is quiet and it just honestly feels like it's just me and him. So that's the times that I love to read. And then the last thing I have on my list of questions is, do I have any ending encouraging comments for others in the same place, or those who are afraid to start because of feelings of being intimidated? If reading the Bible is something that you really want to do and you've had a similar experience as I had with being intimidated by reading, I would just encourage you to go to your local bookstore, find a study guide that works best for you. Like I said, they have so many different ones for you to purchase. I'll link the ones that I'm like, the all the books that I'm using in the description box below, but that's something that I feel has really, really changed my experience. It really helps to like go through and break down everything for you. And instead of you like sitting there reading, thou hast, was thou wilt, and thou shalt not, That was so hard for me to read. Like, I could not get through that. So study Bibles, just speak in a way that you are familiar with, like as I'm speaking to you right now. The great thing about the study guide is that they typically answer your questions in the detail at the bottom of each of the pages. And sometimes even when I'm going through and highlighting, you know, like when you highlight different sections that resonate with you more or speak to you more, I'll even highlight sections at the bottom, like the detail parts, instead of just the scripture itself, because I feel like that's really helped me a whole lot. So this is an example of what I mean about the detail at the bottom of the page. So all of this, just this up here, this alone is scripture. This down here is additional detail on the scripture that you just read. I highly recommend this Bible as well, because it has this particular, so I told you, I'm in like three different books right now. I've started some books and I haven't finished them. So I'm in Psalms and Proverbs, and I'm about to start Mark. So the great thing about this Bible is it also comes with like multiple bookmarks, and I just have my, oh no. Okay, thank God. I just have my own bookmark that I use for Mark. And so I'm in three different places in the Bible at one time. And yeah, this really helped me to have that separated in all the different sections that I'm in. Somebody who I've been following on YouTube on my journey of just getting a closer relationship with God and breaking down scripture is Melody Alyssa. I hope I'm not butchering her name. I'm pretty sure her name is Melody Alyssa. Her page is amazing for breaking down scripture and making it just easier to consume. And the way she speaks to you is just like, she's like one of your friends. So in one of her videos, she was talking about some pens that she uses to highlight her Bible. And these pens are specifically like formulated so they don't bleed through the pages, because the pages are like kind of fragile. They're very thin. And these are by a company called Mr. Pen, and they are their sleek gel highlighters. I have an entire pack of them. I'll link those in the description box as well. And it literally like looks like this. It's already chewed because I've been using it. Absolutely love this because it doesn't bleed through and it's like a gel, like it's just so smooth when I'm highlighting the different sections in the Bible. I also love the color ranges that it has. And it's so funny, I was talking to my best friend the other day, and we were just talking about like God and, you know, reading and all of that kind of stuff. And she showed me her Bible, what she had studied, and she had the same pens that I had. And I just was like, yeah, I hope that this video has encouraged you, if you are interested in reading the Bible for yourself, to not be intimidated. Like, just try. Definitely start with a study Bible that works for you. Get yourself a notebook that's dedicated to you taking notes and that kind of thing, and just set the goal and just do it. Just try your best. And if it doesn't work out one day, so I don't read every single day, but I do read all of my readings that are required for the week, because that will throw the rest of my year off with my readings. So if I miss a day or two because life is lifing, then I pick it up the next day. Or if I'm unable to read the entire week, which typically does not happen, then Sunday I make it a goal, or I make it my business to finish my readings and complete the week. So yeah, anyway, I hope this video was really helpful for you guys. I just hope that this encouraged you, if you are on a journey of reading the Bible and you are wanting to at least attempt and start. This is something that really resonated with you. This is something that really encouraged you to want to do it. And yeah, the last thing I wanted to say is that when, so like a couple, I would say like 4 years ago when I was working at my last job. My coworker came to work super happy one day. She was like, "I'm so excited." And I'm like, what's up? She's like, "My daughter just finished reading the Quran." And I was like, "Oh, well, how old is she?" She was like 12. And I was like this was my face, like, what? But on the inside, I was like, you haven't even read the Bible, man. She's 12 and she read the Quran. Whether or not she understood all of what she read, that doesn't matter. She read it, okay? And I just felt like, man, like, girl, you gotta get on it. Like, you got kids reading through, like, their source of truth. Like, girl, you need to read through yours. So if you are interested in reading through the Bible or trying, then I would highly recommend that you guys try and get yourself a study Bible. Don't be like me. Don't be like the old me. Be like the new me. Get yourself a study Bible and let's get to it. Thank you for watching my video. If you like the content, be sure to leave a like. If you have any questions or comments for me, write a comment in the comment section. And if you enjoyed the content and you want to stick around a little bit longer, hit the subscribe button.